Vector curve fitting technology has been around for many years and is best represented in tools such as a pencil tool, where a user can draw using a mouse or stylus, and this freeform drawing is then automatically converted into Bézier curves. Astute Graphics' own tool, DynamicSketch, has been using Adobe's internal curve fitting technology for many years, but it's only recently with DynamicSketch version 2.1 that we replaced it with our own curve fitting technology so that profiles of sketches are better represented in curves and corners. Let me demonstrate this with the basic DynamicSketch panel, and I will sketch out a letter M fairly smoothly, in this case using a mouse. And once completed, you can see two elements. Firstly, there is the original sketch trail being shown. That's the light thin line. And then there is the actual rendered vectors, which is the blue thicker line. You can see that the original sketch trail is fairly crude, but the resultant vectors are a bit smoother. I can go and alter the settings for the smoothness and the accuracy using the DynamicSketch panel. First, I'll increase the accuracy level so that you can see that the curve is better fitting the trail. And if I decrease it, the opposite happens. Equally, if it decreases smoothness or increases smoothness, you can see the adjustments being made live. I'm going to redraw this letter M, but intentionally have more jagged inputs with the mouse. This represents, perhaps in finer detail, how illustrators tend to draw. They don't tend to be as accurate or as smooth as you'd hope for because of the level of attention you're paying to details. And you can see these sort of little jagged details are represented in the vectors initially. But if I reduce the accuracy and increase the smoothness, you can see a much more fluid result is automatically represented to the designer. One important note is that the corners also remain very sharp. These have not been blunted.